Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over making a very simple, interactive error checking routine with Kismet. The result is going to be a few doors that will only open if you have the correct key. So, I already built one that's working, and let's test this out. So let's play from here. So if we walk up to this door, we get a message that says use the gold key to open the door, and the door doesn't open. If I walk up to this key, it tells me I have the gold key. Then I can walk up to the door and it opens. Alright, great. So let's take a look at the Kismet, and then let's set up this so that it only works if we have this key. So here's the sequence. It's relatively simple. What we're going to do is, with the other one, we're going to set it up so that if you touch the key, you will actually take the key out of the sequence. So you can set up an actor called destroy interp actor. The next is toggling a variable that says that we have the gold key. So in this case, it's you either have the gold key or you don't have the gold key, and the variable is a boolean. The next one is, the next chunk of the sequence is the trigger by the door. So you walk up to the door and you touch the trigger. Then it checks the sequence, it checks the boolean. It says, do you have the gold key? If you do, if that's true, then you can open the door. If it's not true, nothing happens. If it's false, nothing happens. So, if it was false, we could just give an error message saying you need the gold key. In fact, that's probably the better way to set it up. So we could say this, take this comment out, and create a log here. I'm holding down the L key and clicking. And the log is going to say, in the event that we don't have the gold key, play this message. Alright, so let's set up key over here to do the same thing. So the first thing that you need to make sure is that this object is an interp actor. So right now it's a static mesh actor. I'm going to right click, I'm going to convert it to a mover. Now it's an interp actor. The other one I had was so now it's an interp actor. The other thing that I had was, the other one was rotating. So I set this up and I turned it into a rotator and I had it rotate, like, you know, a bit. And the other thing is we need to set up some collision. So we don't really need for it to, we could have it block all, but I think touching all is what we want, because if the character walks up to it and touches it. The next step is I want to change the color on this, change the default texture. So one of the things I've done is I've built a quick texture inside of UDK in my package. So I have a green glow. So I can replace the texture in this of this object. I can change the texture by going under the dynamic SM actor. It's always under the static mesh component. And then I will look under rendering. And here's the materials tab. By clicking this, I can add a new item. And then I can plug in an override here. This creates a beginning of an array, and here's the override. So if I select the material in my browser, so this is a material called Green Glow that I built. I click it, now I've replaced that. Now this is changed color. So let's just double check to make sure that's all working. There it is, it's green and the object's spinning. So now let's go into Kismet and set this up. New event when this is touched. New event using interp actor touched. And now when it's touched, what will I do? I will destroy that. I could hide it also. So I'm going to, and that's under new action actor destroy. And then when it's touched, the target is this. So I'm going to right click here and create new And then I'm going to set the variable. Right click and say new variable, Boolean. And by default it comes in false. And then I need to set that Boolean to true because that means I have the green key. So that's a new action that's setting a variable. Specifically, it's setting a Boolean variable. And you can notice that the nub here at the bottom is the same as the color of the variable. So in fact, this would not attach because this is an interp actor variable. So the target is this. If I name this, we'll call this the green key. That's the variable name. And that's the target. The value, I want another Boolean variable, so I'm going to hold down B and click. The value I want it to be is true. So if I hit 1 and enter, and that should do it for touching the key and making the key go away and then setting the variable to true. So now let's set this up, which we have already done in a previous video, so that it won't open unless we have the green key. So let's go back here and let's find that sequence. Here's the sequence where we're opening that door. So I'm going to unlink this sequence by holding down Alt and clicking. And then I'm going to do a create a conditional, a comparison, in fact. I'm going to say anytime this is clicked, I want to check to see if we have the variable, and if it's true, then we can open the door. If it's false, nothing will happen. So the Boolean that I want is it's a named variable. So what I did with the variable down here was I named it gold key. So I could conceivably go all the way and attach this to the gold key. Looks horrible, and you want to keep your Kismet as clean as possible. So I'm going to go under new variable, named variable, and that named variable is gold key. If you get a green check mark, that means it's found the variable, and then it will be able to successfully check to see if that variable is true or false. The expected type should be a Boolean, and so the Boolean is being checked, and the result, I should call this the green key, because in fact we want to check to see if the green key is working. That would have been a mistake. Okay. There we go. It's working. Okay, one of the things that I noticed was that I had these variables reversed. The Boolean that I'm checking needs to be the green key, and the result is what I'm checking against. Alright, so that's it. Let's stop here, and thanks for watching.